100 billion 2030. A year.
But 55%.
Paris is 1.5 degrees target.
Net zero greenhouse.
75% of the total number of ADVs operation remains in court.
It is important on a COP26 to stress the important role of climate finance, especially in fulfilling the obligation of developed countries to realize the commitment of 100 billion per year by 2020.
Global estimates for adaptation financing are expected to range from USD 140 billion to 300 billion per annum by 2030. Fiji alone would require about $4.6 billion by 2030 to adequately ingrain adaptation and resilience into our development agenda. Every country must ensure the NDCs have a 2030 commitment that is consistent with what the science requires of us. This means no backsliding, no shortfalls, and no deferrals.
We will hold firm on our ambitious climate finance target. There, by 2030, 75% of the total number of ADB's operation will support either adaptation or mitigation, climate action.
55% of the world has accepted to take the measures necessary now to get the 1.5 degrees. And the reason this is so urgent, it's not a matter of trying to corner people or push people to do something that's unreasonable. It's a matter of trying to do what we know is necessary to get the job done.
So we have less than a decade left to keep Paris's 1.5 degrees target within reach. And that will require us to halve our emissions by 2030. So COP26 has to be the moment we get the world on track to make the goals of the Paris Agreement a reality and to keep that 1.5 alive.
Arresting climate change requires achieving net zero greenhouse gas emissions at a global scale by mid-century, and it is an urgent task. Acting later can be extremely costly and may turn out to be ineffective. But shifting economic development towards a sustainable path is a difficult process, and all human activities have to facilitate it. A successful transition requires, therefore, strong global cooperation.